Good morning. I want us to welcome you to worship at Union Center Methodist Church, where we love God and praise God through loving each other on this happy Father's Day, right? So, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior and Heavenly Father, I would like to once more welcome and thank you all who are here in person or are joining us through our online platform like YouTube and Facebook or our live stream. We are so glad that you are here with us and worship together this morning. I hope and pray that the power of the Holy Spirit will be present to touch our heart and mind as we worship together this morning. Let us pray. O God, we are your people. Our souls wait for you. And in your love and mercy, we hope that may your truth be with everybody who waiting your peace and grace. And may you also extend the love to all your people this morning. Father God, we also thank you for your kindness in bringing us all together this morning. We ask for our hearts and minds open to your presence as we gather to worship you. Fill this place with your Holy Spirit and our soul with your peace. Let every song, pray, and words spoken glorify your name and draw us closer in communion with you and each one another. In your name we pray and we worship you. Amen.
Children of God, the Spirit you receive does not make you slaves so that you live in fear again. Rather, the Spirit you received brought about your adoption to sonship. And by him we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit himself testifies with our spirit that we are God's children. Now if we are children, then we are heirs, heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ, if indeed we share in his sufferings, in order that we may also share in his glory. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you. all standing together, let's say together our Apostles' Creed. This is what we believe.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
You please be seated. Our first reading this week is from our New Testament. We're into the book of Matthew, chapter 7, verses 9 through 11. Which of you, if your son asks for bread, will he give him a stone? Or if he asks for a fish, will give him a snake? If you, then, though you are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father in heaven give good gifts to those who ask him? Amen. Our Old Testament reading is from our book of Psalms, chapter 103. I thought it said 10. Verses 8 through 14. The Lord is compassionate and gracious, slow to anger, abounding in love. He will not always accuse, nor will he harbor his anger forever. He does not treat us as our sins deserve or repay us according to our iniquities. For as high as the heavens are above the earth, so great is his love for those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our transgressions from us. As a father has compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear him. For he knows how we are formed. He remembers that we are dust. Amen. Now let's enjoy our special music from Eric.
Thank you.
Thank you, Eric. Well, just as we honored our moms, today's that special day when we get to honor our dads. Now, Don's been ready since Mother's Day. He came with that look on him this morning. Here's Don's candy bar. Stephen, would you like to pass out all our candy bars? How about if we have our dads stand up? If you're a dad, a granddad, an uncle, stepfather, come on, stand up if that's what you want. And don't forget Eric, he's an uncle. Sometimes it's the same. Oh, and Pastor Jay, thank you. Thanks, sweetie. Oh, yeah, we'll get you. They're on hold. We'll just take. Who's got? Gentlemen, you're in church. Remember, Jesus is listening. Who's got a story they'd like to tell about their dad? Amy, you got a story about your dad you want to? Thanks. Come on, who's got a story about their dad? Shannon's got a story about her dad.
So my father was a teacher when he first got out of college. He graduated and he was a teacher. And then I became a teacher. Unfortunately, I only had about 4 weeks with him before he passed away, but I think the greatest joy that I had with my father was calling him to tell him about the experiences I had walking into a classroom the first time and just laughing together and sharing that, you know, just while he was not well and not feeling well, I did get to share some things with him. So I'm just remembering my father, loved him. He was a wonderful person. He loved this church. He loved this church family, and he loved the kids that came here. So, anyway.
Who else in the back?
My father died when I was 2 years old, unfortunately. I have a lot of stories about him, though. But then I had a stepdad. My mother remarried when I was 8, and I thanked the Lord for him. And then I became a Christian and learned to know my Heavenly Father, and I thank the Lord for those three influences in my life.
Amen. Amen.
My dad, he was very special. I don't really remember him too well because he passed away when I was 8 years old, but he was a sergeant in Salvation Army. He believed in God, and he fathered 17 children. 12 boys and 5 girls, and he was a great dad.
Amen. Wonderful, wonderful.
I just want to say happy Father's Day to everyone here, and a special happy Father's Day to my dad for being there for me, supporting me throughout this journey, and working hard so I can be where I am today.
Oh,
Happy Father's Day. Last 15 years, my dad is not here. He passed away. In his old days, he received Lord Jesus Christ. He baptized and went to the Lord.
Amen.
It is wonderful to celebrate, remember the fathers in our community. I thank God for my dad, who has always been there for me whenever I needed him. He raised me, held my hand, and taught me how to walk throughout my academic journey. His prayers have been with me constantly. My dad was inspired by my grandfather, a man of integrity, love, and care for our family. I'm grateful to him, his moment of honor, all the fathers around the world. I also thank my church family members. They are remembering us in their personal prayer. Thank you.
Amen. Meal's done.
What I will probably remember until I can find out a little bit more is that when Gene Cornett told me that my father was in real estate and actually sold her a house down in West Endicott, is on June Street, and I had no idea that he was anything to do with real estate or mm-hmm. who he worked for or anything like that. So when I get up there, I'm going to certainly find out. So.
Have your list of questions ready.
Been sitting here, how I can say this delicately. My father had a very strong personality. You either loved him or you didn't. But he was so supportive of my music career. He would drive 6 hours when I was in college to hear me play in a general recital. That is amazing to me. So maybe his personality wasn't that great, but he was very supportive of my career.
My father was more than a father, he was my best friend. And I was lucky growing up. We did everything together. We hunted, we fished, and I did something that probably not a whole lot of boys do. I played softball with him. He was our pitcher, and I played shortstop. And we did an awful lot of winning, and I never forget him.
Amen. Anyone else?
My dad passed away several years ago at the age of 89. And he used to say to me, Grant, I'm in my golden years. Where's the gold? He was very funny. He always kidded around like that. But I remember one summer in particular when my dad and I spent a whole summer pick and shoveling beneath our home and expanding our cellar. And we had a lot of time to bond together at that time. And my little brother Wayne would come around and he'd drop pebbles when we were shoveling it out, you know. And my dad would yell at him and go out and chase him around the house. But we had some great times together, and he was a wonderful dad. He was a World War II veteran in the Pacific on the USS Idaho in World War II, and didn't talk about it much. But I'm sure there's a lot of things that he didn't want to remember. But I'm very proud of him. I miss him, and I know that someday I'll see him again.
First thing I remember about my dad when I was a little kid was that we never saw him, because most of the time when I was growing up, he worked three jobs, and at home was where he spent the least amount of time. But in those days, you know, it was a lot harder to make ends meet. But he was never, ever afraid of work. I used to kid him after he retired. Right after the 1st of September, he'd sit in the dining room and look out the window. And the first leaf that fell out of the trees, he started to rake. And
did we used to get him, he got the rake gene because nobody else in the family could do it. I have seen him work 8 to 10 hours at a time, nonstop, and just making sure that his lawn looked the best in the neighborhood. And I wish I had been more like him and less like my mom's side of the family, but you just can't pick and choose.
Did you want?
My father was a policeman for 25 years in Endicott, and for 26 years he was a judge in the town of Union. And I do remember one case in the court where the father had his son there, and I'm not sure if it was trespassing or something, and through the whole thing, the father sat there and whistled. Now my father sets the fine. And the father, of course, says something, and my father sat there and whistled right back. But he was 1 month short of 93. Oh. Miss him a lot. He had a lot of questions. He was a smart man for just graduating eighth grade.
Wow. So. Anybody else? Oh, we have one more.
Hi, I'm Barbara Rippick, and this is my husband, Paul. We come in once in a while to visit. My father was a pastor of the Congregational United Church of Christ in Endicott for 12 years, and Emily and I were quite a challenge. We both were there. She and I were in youth group, and my dad had a lot of patience. We sang in the choir, and the choir director had a lot of patience, and we were mischievous, let's put it that way, being a preacher's kid. But he loved us and just let us grow in church and in Christ, and that was a very important part of our lives.
Anyone else have anything they want to share about their dad? Does anybody have any prayer requests or joys? I don't know how would. Any joys or blessings? Any prayer requests this week?
I can make this work for my Heavenly Father. Okay. This week I ran into a verse, James 5:16. The prayer of a righteous person is powerful and effective. Well, I'm sure I've read that 100 times before, but it just struck me, and I was talking to my daughter, and I said, that's really awesome, isn't it? It's just, I mean, it's so profound. So we talked for a while, then fast forward to Thursday, and she had her final doctor's appointment for another test. She had been experiencing some difficulties, and some of the tests didn't look too encouraging. And I said, do you want me to go with you? And she said, no, I have a doctor's appointment right after the test. I'll call you from the parking lot. I said, okay. So she called and she said, are you ready for this? And I said, yes. And she says, the doctor says there's absolutely nothing there anymore, and you can go home and have a good day.
Amen.
And I said, I just wrote this verse and I had it in my hand. And I mean, it reminded me of Linda, and I thought, you know, we don't always get the answer we want. But I just have to say thank you to him and praise his name.
Amen. Amen. Anybody else? Prayer requests or? No? Okay. How about if we bow our heads and close our eyes? Let's have a moment of silent prayer together. I'll pray and then we'll have our Lord's Prayer together. Precious Father, oh, how I love to say that, Father. We thank you for taking us into your family, for making us your children, Father. This morning, we're so grateful. We're so grateful for those that are here, for the dads that are here, the dads that have gone on before us, and those future dads that are here. This morning we're praying for those that are going through any type of tests or procedures, Father, upcoming surgeries. We pray for each and every one of them, Father. We ask that you guide the doctors and the nurses. And Father, you know the outcome, but like Lynn, we all want that ultimate, and Linda, we all want that ultimate, all is well, all is clear. Have a good day. Father, we're thankful for all of our senior saints, whether they're here with us today, whether they're watching us, or whether they're in nursing homes and camp. Please, Father, put it in our hearts and our minds to pray for each and every one of them so that we let them know that they are still loved and appreciated and needed, Father. We thank you, Father, for Pastor Jay and Mia and the kids. We thank you, Father, for the beautiful church and sanctuary that you've given us, that we can come, we can sing, we can pray. Father, we don't have to look over our shoulder or be afraid, for we know that we are safe in your house. Thank you, Father, for the traveling mercies that you've given us this week. We ask that you be with each and every one of us as we travel either on vacation or business or just pleasure, Father, be with us. And with that, Father, we all pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses. Lead us not those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Let's all stand together for our next hymn, Dear Lord and Father of Mankind.
all be seated. Thank you. Father, it is incredible and fundamental job that God has given to the world. So I want to say thank you the way of you are doing, right? Let's give it up for all fathers here. Thank you. And also, I want to share God's message with all of you this morning. And it comes from the Bible, that comes from the New Testament, Romans chapter 5, 1 and 8 through 11. And let me read for everyone. Therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. But God demonstrates his one love for us in this. While we are still sinners, Christ died for us. And since we have now been justified by his blood, how much more shall we be saved from God's wrath through him? For if, while we are God's enemies, we were reconciled to him through the death of his Son, how much more, having been reconciled, shall we be saved through his life? Not only is this so, but we also boast in God through our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him, we have now received reconciliation. Amen. Won't you pray with me? Loving and gracious God, we humbly came before you to ask for your favor and blessing on this sermon today. May you bless this message with your wisdom and knowledge. May you help us to take your words and apply it into our lives and spiritual journey. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight. Our Lord, our God, our rock, and our Redeemer. Amen. Today is Father's Day. Happy Father's Day, right? So it may not surprise you that, I'm going to be talking about fathers and children, right? But to be honest, I was not planning to preach on the topic of fathers today. However, after considering that I discussed the topic of mothers on Mother's Day, I felt that it would be unfair not to address the topic of fathers on Father's Day. And I also thought it would be meaningful to discuss this topic today. That's why I would like to talk about father and children this morning. Let me ask you a question. Those of you here, fathers, please put your hands up. Fathers. Yeah, thank you. Father, like I said, is an incredible, important, and fundamental job in terms of what God has given to the world. And I thank you for the way that you are doing that. But some of you may be thinking, well, I'm not a father, and I didn't get to raise my hand. So as the result of that, is this message that you are about to preach reverent, relevant for me? Or am I just listening on what you are telling to fathers? But I promise you, that is not the case. It is going to be relevant for you, everyone here this morning. Let me turn this question around slightly, and let's see whether you still have the question. Is it going to be relevant for you? How many of you in here have fathers or have had fathers? Please raise your hand. Right? And so you see, the reason that you are laughing is that this is the case for everybody, right? That's why today you are the target audience. We are all children who have or have had fathers. What does it mean? We all have or have had fathers. It means that we are at the same time fathers who have children, right? And more of the relationship between father and children is fundamental to making our homes on this planet truly sweet home, as indicated by today's theme, home, sweet home. This is because the heart of the home always involves fathers and their children. Think about this. Is a home without father and children even possible? No. It's like not calling a gathering of close friends or groups a home, because there is no relationship between children and fathers. Home basically distinguishes the relationship between father and their children from any other intimate relationship based on benefits or needs on this planet. In fact, considering this, the only places that can be called home on this earth are your own family and the church, right? Let's follow the verse. But when the right time came, God sent his son, born of a woman, subject to the law. God sent him to buy freedom for us who were slaves to a law, so that he could adopt us as his very own children. And because we are his children, God has sent his spirit of his son into our heart, prompting us to call out, Abba, Father. Now you are no longer a slave, but God's own child. And since you are his child, God has made you his heir. Galatians chapter 4, verse 4 through 7. Just as such, home is a place where our physically and spiritually weary bodies and souls can rest and recover. A place of love and recharge. Most importantly, it is where our beloved family is. The reason we walk, strive, and endure in the world. And the place where we find the meaning and joy of our life. That's the home. Because of this, many people in our society use the term home in a very good, positive, and productive manner. For example, hometown, homecoming, home run, home shopping, Home Depot, home goods, homemade style kitchen, food, restaurant, so on. Thus, it would be a very sad and regrettable event if such a home were to disappear or be lost for some reason. There's one in a family, one in an elementary school during the fall. I went on autumn picnic with my friends. Even at a young age, I vividly remember the high and blue autumn sky being incredibly beautiful and peaceful, and the wind being cool. I tried to catch dragonflies flying over the field and ended up falling asleep in a flower bath. It was really tired. When I opened my eyes, there was no children in my sight. And the field was totally empty, the blue sky turning the color of the sunset. At that moment, even at a young age, I started to fear the coming darkness. However, the thought of not being able to return home and see my beloved family was much a scary thought. You know, as young as I was, it was a pretty scary thought. I couldn't see my family and couldn't return home anymore. After thinking that scary thought to myself, all of a sudden, someone began calling my name from below the hill. Jaehoon, Jaehoon. And then my father appeared right in front of me. I remember starting to cry with the tears I had been holding back. The warmth and peace I felt is when I was carried on my father's back on the way home are unforgettable memory. I think that you have ever had like this experience, aren't you? The term sweet home might be the first to come to mind when thinking of people and family. This is because a home is the most comfortable and peaceful space where love among family members can blossom. However, it is regrettable that homes are increasingly becoming places of conflict and hurt. At the center of these issues and conflict are the fundamental relations between relationships within the family, particularly between fathers and their children. Therefore, for true freedom, as the Lord said, the restoration of the relationship between children and fathers must come first. Let's look at the following first. Therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this. While we are still sinners, Christ died for us. Since we have not been justified by his blood, how much more shall we be saved from God's wrath through him? For if, while we are God's enemies, we were reconciled to him through the death of his son, how much more, having been reconciled, shall we be saved through his life? And not only it is this so, but we also boast in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. The relationship between fathers and children is ironically one of love and hate each other. In other words, because they know each other's love so well, they can also inflict pain, disappointment, and betrayal on each other. Children sometimes think that they had to give up a better life due to their father's incompetence, that they could no longer stay together because of their father's stubborn nature and streak, well, that they had to give up a lot for themselves due to their father's indifference and selfishness, which is leads to anger. Fathers become strict with the children who chase dreams instead of reality and impose on them the achievement they themselves did not reach. Ultimately, peace is broken and the sweet home we hope for turns into a dark house. Thus, God says that true reconciliation can be restored through the love and forgiveness shown through his son, Jesus Christ. It is then that our relationships and families can truly experience restoration. But generally speaking, I can see sometimes that is happening inside of your heads. Yeah, but Pastor Jay, you just do not know about my father. You don't have any idea about my parents, particularly my father. Or you might say, Pastor, you don't even know my dad, and I'm not really sure. That's right. But one thing for sure is that unless reconciliation, forgiveness, and love are restored between father and their children, a sweetheart will be not only a distant dream, but also we can't witness Holy Spirit's touch and work. Here is a story of a true love and restoration in a family through forgiveness and reconciliation. It's about Bart, the lead singer of a Christian band, and his father based on a true story. Let me tell you a story briefly. Bart lived with his mother and his stubborn, violent father, Arthur. His father's violence and verbal abuses worsened over time, and his mother, hoping Bart would find faith and meet Jesus Christ, sent him to a church retreat. However, when Bart returned home, his mother ended up leaving the house due to his father's violence, verbal abuses. Eventually, it was just Bob and his father left at home. His dreams was to become a professional soccer player, NFL, but an injury made it impossible for him to play soccer anymore. Forced to join the choir to earn high school credits, Bart discovered his great talent for music and became immersed in it. However, his father disdained him for it and became even more violent. Eventually, Bart had a big fight with his father and left home. And he started making music in a Christian band. He wanted to produce his music into an album and went to look for a record label. However, the record label's evaluation was negative because they felt his song seemed insincere, as if not coming from the heart. Barth, though reluctant to admit it, agreed with the producer's comments and while pondering his true self and the problem, thought that the issue at home, the anger in her heart, might be the cause. So he decided to return home to resolve that. However, he was shocked and increasingly angered by the completely changed, warm, gentle, and deeply faithful appearance of his father. Bart did not forgive his father, who asked for forgiveness. Just as he was about to leave home again, he found out in his father's car that his father did not have long to live due to developed cancer. Believing that his father's action and heart was sincere in the face of death, he forgave him finally. They spent a true, happy, and beautiful time together for a while. However, his father died soon after, urging Bart not to give up on his dreams. Bart came to praise the forgiveness and love for his father, and that is exactly what the song I Can Only Imagine is about. Please let us sing together on the screen. The song by him and his band has become one of the most sung and sold in the history of American Christianity. Let's take a look at it on the screen.
Will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I can only is forever, forever worship you. can only imagine when all I will do is forever, forever worship you. I can only imagine.
To come to realize that true happiness and blessing come not only from the meeting the true self within. When you truly forgive a loved one, despite sometimes feeling anger and hatred, he testifies and prays that through this, truly family reconciliation is achieved. On this Father's Day, if there are any unforgettable, unforgiven grievances or unreconciled matters, I pray and hope that through true forgiveness and reconciliation, your family will become a true, sweet home. Amen. So now as we go to our closing hymn together, the faith of our fathers. Please stand if you are able as we sing together. Let us pray here the benediction. As we go from here, remember this. God's love is from everlasting to everlasting, from generation to generation. Just as a father has a compassion on his children, so God has a compassion on those who fear him, who listen to his voice, and who do his will. Go out in the knowledge that the everlasting love of God goes with you now and forever. And God's people say, Amen.